Okay, we fixed 77 turns. The thickness of a piece of plywood that's a half inch that this stator is going to also be, a half inch. The plywood is actually 15/32 due to planing at the factory to make it nice and smooth. Well, at that 15/32 is 7 pieces of 14 gauge wire side by side. Fit in there just right. So 7 times 11 means 11 pieces of 14 gauge wire, because I'm doing the 24 volt system. Put this right up against the edge of my form of my magnet that I drew, and I draw my line. And the same thing over here, and you can see I've already done this. Had a few bad takes with the camera. You draw your lines, and you draw your line all the way on out past where you think the coil is going to be, because you'll round that off afterward. But the thing is, this line right here is the edge of the parameter that this coil can fit in. And that would be a little bit smaller than my magnet due to that. This makes sure that your coils will fit. And here it just barely touches the edge, but I'm going to go ahead and bring it in just to give myself a little bit of room for error. Sometimes the wires don't all just line up perfect like that, and some of them do like this, and they take up a little bit more room as you wrap it. Wind them neatly, but don't get over fastidious. A coil shouldn't take you an hour to do. It should take you maybe 5-10 minutes. If you're going to sit there and line each piece up and then tap your wire and line it, it's going to take you forever. It's a headache, and you're going to miss the joy of building this anyway. And having the coil perfect really doesn't change its performance. Okay, the next thing is to draw where all the magnets are going to sit, because I need to explain one more thing. If this is a magnet, and this is my next magnet, this is north, this is south, the magnetic flux is being pushed on this side, pulled on this one, and pushed on this side, so you wind up having 3 magnets operating your coil. If you got too many magnets and they're close like this, guess what? It's not going around the coil. Not good, and a lot of your magnetism is swapping from magnet to magnet instead of across to the other magnet. So having spaced out, we're using 12 magnets, or 12 magnet position, 24 magnets, seeing as it's a dual axial flux rotor. Okay, one more thing I didn't explain here. Trace the shape of the inside of your coil. Now I have the shape of the inside of my coil winder, dead center, is where we'll drill. There's the half inch piece. And I'll center this up, glue it on here. And basically from there out, all I have to do is take it to the belt sander and sand off what I don't need. And there's my coil winder inside. Or shall I say it, my coil winder form. And then we'll assemble the rest of the coil winder. And what I've done here is I've colored these just for a few demonstration purposes, and one bit of theory that I think would be very interesting to you, and I think most people really ought to know, especially if you're going to design alternators. The reason why I'm showing you everything the way I'm showing you is because I don't want anybody to say, oh, I have to get this certain brand of this or that, but like I said, I don't know what disc I have. I just have measurements of it. Okay, so knowing all this stuff and showing you how I designed and found the size of my coil and all that, and how many windings for what size and what size prop, gives you something to go by if you want, or you can use other programs on the web. If this is a north magnet, north, 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 which I've colored all orange, and these ones I did in blue, I found, show you the way I did this. Paint stick, put a hole in it in the center. Try to get mine exactly center so my magnets aren't perfect straight. Try it this way, it works better. There we go. Put them like this. You know the one in the 3 o'clock position over here is south. If this is north, south, north, south, this is south. North, south, north, and go all the way around. You can draw your magnets in, finding your angles. Okay. If this magnet is north and these two are south, notice they're not real close over here. They're out over here. This is good design. This means I'm using this magnet, and this magnet to power this coil. Magnetic flux is coming from these and into this one. and going around. When the blue one gets here, then it goes the opposite way. And any position in between, that magnetic flux in the middle changes. This is one of the points I wanted to make. This coil right here is not generating in this position. You would think it would, because seeing as the magnetic flux is at maximum, and then when the blue one's here and two orange ones here, you'd figure it's generating again. No, that's not. That's where your waveform comes down, hits center, and then starts generating the other direction and winds up going to center. I'll explain. It only generates when the magnetic flux changes. That's why you can't just leave a magnet and put this coil on top of it and expect to get electricity out of it. This magnet has to move. It either needs to move farther away, move through it, or it needs to move sideways, whichever. Anything that will change the amount of magnetic flux that's going through the coil, or the direction of the magnetic flux. So as the magnetic flux is going through here, coming from here and going in here, and this moves over here, now we have a decrease in magnetic flux in here, and this coil is generating, probably in the negative direction, and then it gets to the top of its wave here, and now it starts to go the other direction, seeing as this magnetic flux right here is stronger than the magnet that's over in this position. So the wave is going down. When this blue magnet finally gets here, that means it's made it to center again. And as that magnet passes, it starts on its journey again, makes your wave. Let's go back to the layman's theory of its generating at peak here. We have north, north, north. These coils right here, these angles right here represent the parameters for the coils. These three coils right here, here, and here will be connected. There'll be a start here, and it'll wind around. It'll come over here, wind around this one, and pass around here, wind around here, and the electron finally leaves out this way. So you have a start over here, and a finish. All the coils on this are wound the same direction. This one, and this one are connected. This coil, and this coil are connected. This coil, and this coil are connected for three full phases. Three sets of three coil, 12 magnets. For every three coils, you need four magnets, or four magnet positions. And that's the rule for a three-phase alternator. Now I've got this explained. Notice over here, this is a coil. This one's leaving. This coil right here is generating because this magnet is leaving.
Hello, I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and Other Home Energies. One more thing I want to add before I leave this video. I always promise to show you as many shortcuts as I possibly can. This one's pretty cool. If you look up here, you notice this north magnet is on the line. This north magnet is dead center between the lines, but it is 180 degrees over. Look over here, this one's between, but this one's on. This one's between, but this one's on. In other words, when I go like this, that should line me right up for the opposite side. And the same thing for that one because of this one and this one over here. So all I got to do is find this line, and this line, and I can get the other ones. These other ones are dead center between. Saves you from having to pull out your protractor and figure new angles and draw a whole bunch of lines. This sure does work a lot nicer. All your lines are already there that you're going to need. And anyway, that made that a lot easier. And one other thing, down here, after drawing the shape of my coil, put a piece of paper down there, trim off what you don't need. Then you put it on a piece of wood here, glue it down. You can scroll saw it, jigsaw it, sawzall it. I wouldn't suggest a table saw or a skill saw, but I imagine it could be done. Not with much safety, though. What I plan to do is glue this down, stick a screwdriver through the hole in the middle, and hang on to it. I'm going to take my belt sander with 80 grit sandpaper, and I'm going to sand that bad boy down and keep it level. I'm going to sand it down until it gets to the paper, and I'll be done. That's the center of our coil winder. Thank you very much. I'm Scott Brown with Green Wind and Other Home Energies. Many good things to you and yours.